Here are all the secret little things you did not know these animals had. Number 9. Darwin's Bark Spiderweb. There's still a lot to discover when it comes to the animal kingdom, and Africa is living proof of that. In this particular case, we're talking about a spider with a huge web. The Darwin Bark Spider is found on the island of Madagascar. It's become somewhat of a household name. It's not just your average spider. That's because of its web-building skills. Its web is so strong, it's over 10 times stronger than Kevlar. It's the toughest known biological material known. These guys also produce the largest webs known to exist. The webs can easily span over 30 square feet in area. The crazy thing is, these spiders are really small. Males are only around a quarter of an inch, whereas the females are about an inch in body length. So what exactly makes their web so special? It's the elasticity of their web. The molecular constitution of the web has yet to be fully uncovered. Either these spiders are using a specific type of protein to spin their silk, or they've evolved a new way of spinning the silk itself. A better knowledge of either could help develop the artificial silks that mimic the strength of these spiders' silk. Number 8. Soft-shell turtle mouth. Imagine having to pee through your mouth. Yeah, it's gross. But that's exactly what this species of soft-shell turtle does. Researchers at the University of Singapore noticed that these turtles, called Pelodiscus sinensis, would stick their heads into puddles of water and wiggle their tongues. But they were not drinking the water. At first, they thought the turtles had some gill-like structure that could help them breathe if they put their head underwater. But the researchers knew that the turtles had lungs, so they thought, why would they need to do that? After some experiments, the researchers learned that the turtles only did this in order to rinse their mouths of urea. The urea travels through the turtles' bloodstream to their mouths, so it's not technically pee. If the turtles expelled their urea the traditional way, they'd need a lot more water to stay hydrated. These turtles live in slightly salty water, so it's a clever adaptation in order to not have to drink as much water. Just like us, turtles can't expel salt in their urine, so drinking any salty water is just a waste of time. The researchers were interested in these turtles' adaptation. Hypothetically, if active urea excretion mechanisms can be expressed in the mouth of a patient with kidney failure, urea excretion can still occur. Yep, they're thinking of bringing pee to the patient's mouth and rinsing with water. Ugh. Number 7. Secretary Bird Kick. You wouldn't think a bird with long, lanky legs would be extremely efficient at getting a snake, but that's what this bird was evolved to do. The secretary bird isn't exactly a bird known for its services, as its name would indicate. The secretary bird is so unfriendly, it may just kick you if it doesn't like you. Scientists are studying their extreme kicking motion. That's because the research may help design fast-moving robot limbs for prosthetics. The secretary bird lives in sub-Saharan Africa. They're around 4.5 feet tall, and they eat snakes, lizards, and small animals. They basically strut around looking down at the ground the whole time when they're hunting. Their prey are generally snakes, and their kick is extremely fast and extremely accurate. They can do a kick in just 15 milliseconds. Blinking your eyes takes 150 milliseconds. That's how fast they are. They're able to deliver 5 to 6 times their own body weight in a tenth of the time it takes to blink an eye. Many of the snakes that secretary birds feed on are venomous. Going after these snakes with a kick that's weak or slow enough to allow them to fight back would be disastrous. And that's why they developed this insanely fast kick. Number 6. Woodpecker Tongue. We'd bet that you know that woodpeckers are great with wood. But we'd bet that you had no clue that the woodpecker has a crazy tongue. Yep. Woodpeckers use a tongue that's a third of its body length to get its food. How is this even possible? Where do they keep their roughly 4-inch long tongues? Apparently, the woodpecker coils its tongue all the way behind its skull, over its eyes and nostrils. Basically, its whole head is filled with tongue. But why would a woodpecker need such a long tongue? Well, during the spring and summer months, its primary source of food are ants. They tend to hide deep inside wood logs and underneath the soil. The woodpecker's strategy is simple. Stick its face and beak in something, deploy its long, sticky tongue, and then retract to enjoy whatever its tongue brings back. Number 5. Vampire Bat Nose. Vampire bats know exactly where to bite. It's advantageous for them to get in and get out. Vampire bats basically have sensors on their noses, that way they're accurate with their bites. But how? Vampire bites have sensory molecules covering their nerve endings on their noses. These tiny molecules open or close if they perceive the correct stimulus from chemicals, cold, heat, or pressure. One molecule, TRPV1, is a heat-sensing molecule that can detect a temperature increase. That means vampire bats know exactly where to find blood vessels. Similar molecules are found on pain-sensing nerves on such as our tongues and eyes. This allows you to taste spicy food and lets you know when you're touching a hot object. These molecules allow vampire bats to pick up on changing body temperatures because of blood flow. The vampire bat feeds off sleeping animals, including birds and mammals. This is when their sensors' activity peaks. They're able to scan with their noses and find the exact right place to bite. Their prey just keep on sleeping. Isn't that just a little evil? Find out more animals that are evil by watching this video here. Number 4. Tripod fish legs. Why on earth would a fish need legs? Does that even make sense? Well, the tripod fish does need its legs for a reason. These guys have very particular features that make them stand out at the bottom of the sea. They have some really long bony fins that help them stand up. These fins can reach over 3 feet in length, which is a lot considering tripod fish only measure around 12 inches on average. These fins are only used when they're needed. When tripod fish are cruising the waters, the fins function as low-hanging soft limbs. But when the tripod fish needs to stand, the fins get filled with the internal fluid that make them stiffer. Tripod fish need to stay above the seabed. By sitting perfectly still at around 3 feet above the seabed, the tripod fish is perfectly positioned. Tiny prawns, fish, and crustaceans come along on the ocean's current right into its mouth. At the seabed level, this current is virtually non-existent. The tripod fish don't even see its prey coming. That's because of its super dark habitat. The thing is, it doesn't matter because its long fins can feel the vibrations of whatever animal is coming its way. Number 3. Golden Tortoise Beetle Liquid. How awesome is it that there are animals out there that can change colors right before our eyes? The only way to be cooler is to look like a piece of gold almost all the time. The golden tortoise beetle is that cool. The golden tortoise beetle is common in North America, and it can often be found in your backyard. They aren't always gold. They change color depending on the season or even their mood using the liquid beneath their transparent shell. Whenever it feels threatened or under attack, the golden tortoise beetle will use a liquid that covers its internal layers of its body to change colors. It basically squeezes all the liquid out, changing its color from gold to a brownish-orange color in a matter of seconds. Tortoise beetles get their funny name from the peculiar structure of their hardened wing covers that protect their, you guessed it, wings. These covers have a flattened ridge outlining their body and conceal the head and legs, much like a tortoise. Entomologists think that this feature allows them to hunker down and tuck in their body parts when they're under attack from a predator. However, scientists still don't know exactly what the benefit is when they change color. Number 2. Crabeater seal teeth. Why do crabeater seals look like they have teeth that just look like they're saws? Although their name may indicate otherwise, crabeater seals have a much more complex way of eating. They don't actually feed on crabs. Their mouths are literally filled with dozens of teeth that have teeth with even smaller teeth. Teeth over teeth? Yep, their multiple teeth have several dents which themselves work as a strainer for the real food they want to get. The seal takes in some water and then lets it out. These small dents in their teeth help them strain water and the krill, which are microscopic plankton-like crustaceans. These microscopic krill comprise over 90% of the crabeater seal's diet. Krill is also the main food source for blue whales, which are the largest mammal in the world, with an estimated biomass of 500 million tons. Antarctic krill are, by some scientists' estimates, the most abundant animal species on the planet. So, crabeater seals like to eat krill, but interestingly enough, leopard seals love to eat crabeater seals. In fact, for the crabeater seal pups that don't make it, 4 out of 5 times it's because of a leopard seal. Number 1. Narwhals Tusk. Narwhals are essentially unicorns. This whale-like sea mammal is popularly called a sea unicorn. That's because of the tusk they have on their heads. A lot of speculation has surrounded their tusk, just what exactly do they use it for? The tusk is a left canine tooth protruding from the heads of males, and it can grow as long as 9 feet. The right canine stays embedded, and no other teeth protrude from the inside of their mouths. Narwhals instead use suction to swallow their prey whole. Using drone footage, investigators were able to confirm what exactly narwhals do with their long tusks. As expected, they use it to catch prey, but how? Narwhals use their longhorn to directly stun various fish, leaving them immobilized. While the footage confirmed one theory of how narwhals use their tusks, there are other purposes as well, such as being used as an ice pick or as a tool for echolocation.
Here's what's next.